It's been years since I've been gone. I miss the way it feels to roam. This urge that's grown inside my heart to pack my bags and hit the road.
Okay, we're on a pier by the Laguna. I'm here with my friend and colleague, Dr. Jonny Miller.
Hi, how's it going?
So he's a wildlife expert, a biology teacher, and an expedition leader. He's the one who's found these snakes that we're gonna release today. He also has a YouTube channel. What's your channel name again?
It's called Jonny Tropics.
Jonny Tropics, and they've got a really good video on there of the world's most brazenly hidden bird, the great potu. And that's at 950,000 views. So, you know, click the link up here and see if you can get it up to a million. Anyway, let's hear from Jonny.
Hey, okay, so we've got three boa constrictors here. Now, someone actually took these from the wild and has been keeping them as pets. It's a really bad idea. Any wild animal should not be kept in captivity unless it really has to be for its own safety. And this person is no longer able to look after them. And so through the grapevine, they've ended up in my hands because of my previous work with snakes. So today we're gonna be releasing them back into the wild. Now, unlike some other animals like mammals, snakes really retain a strong instinct for hunting and looking for food and ambushing and all the things that they would do naturally in nature. So having come from the wild, even though they've spent time in captivity, they should be fine and happy to be back in the wild. So that's exactly what we're going to do today. So we've come to this national park and found a fantastic area away from any human settlement where they're going to be safe and hopefully live out the rest of their lives just doing their thing. Okay, so let me introduce you to the snakes. We have here a very big and very upset female. So you're gonna hear how upset she is. We have a slightly smaller and less upset male here. Now you can see in here, there's some lunch from earlier that he's decided not to actually take advantage of just yet. But that's okay, he's just a bit too stressed to eat. And they've eaten a few days ago, so they've got their strength up for being back in the wild. And here we have a small male who's really quite sweet. There he is, looking very curious and relaxed.
Okay, I'm here with the whole team. We've got Alejandro as our boat driver. Jonny, you've met already. And we've got Hailey and Mika.
Hello.
They're gonna be helping us to load the snakes onto the boat and release them into the wild.
Afraid of you now.
the crocodile, so we're going to go back and see if he's still there.
It's the reptile vlog.
That's it.
Oh,
if every high comes down, I'm kind of afraid if you know. If every high comes down, I'm kind of afraid if you know. There's nothing left here in the rush.
Boxes off the boat, and we're told there's a great path through here, and all in this direction for kilometers and kilometers is the rest of Jeanette Kawas National Park. So it's just pure wilderness. As you can see, it's difficult to get to. No one really comes along here at all. So we are going to take advantage of this spot. It's ideal habitat for the boas, and this will be their new home.
Can we start with moth?
Yeah.
Boa
marco.
Baby
boo.
La grande.
La grande sexta.
Roughly around here is a good spot for our first boa. There's some really good habitat here, nice primary habitat. We got past all the old palm plantation, which is now part of the park. It's all recovering forest, but here we have beautiful mangrove over there, beautiful mangrove over here. But we've released them right here in the shady spot, so it isn't released immediately into some stressful heat. Yeah, I think this is a good spot. So I think this is a great spot for the boa. I've been in this area before and found boas, so I know that there's a healthy population here. It's protected, it's a protected national park. This particular section has plenty of options. So where we release it just here, it could, for example, climb this tree. That may seem almost impossible, but you'd be amazed by the climbing ability of boas. It could also go into the mangrove swamp in this direction, over onto some dry land over here, over to some more mangrove over there. So it's got loads of options. So we're going to put it right here and see how she gets on. Okay. I'm just going to let her get used to this hook. Okay. No biggie, no stress. Her in that strike position, ready to defend herself. Look how she's already starting to move sideways around the tree. What she's going to do is she's going to clasp on and get her weight around it. If she decides to climb, which she's deciding not to. Yeah. She doesn't really have the confidence for that really vertical thing, although it would have been great to get footage of that because it's such an impressive way of climbing, like a vertical pole. But she's not feeling too confident about that, so we're just going to let her climb up here, give her the chance to get up into the trees as early as possible so that she feels safer. She's got the chance to go down into the undergrowth. I'm just going to back up, let her feel less threatened. She's now up in the trees, and it's so good to see her follow her instincts to climb. Those are expert climbers. She's going to find a spot up there to be able to bask in the sun, wait in ambush for some birds to come along. You can already hear that bird has spotted her and is warning everyone around that there's a boa. So she's got food. Once she settles in, hopefully it won't be long before she can ambush some prey, get a nice meal, carrying her life here. Spot number two for snake number two. Oh, sweetie. Now this one did not want to eat, so it's still got a chick there. This one's a little bit more relaxed than that big angry one. Oh, she wedged herself in there. There we go. Thank you.
8, so pretty unhappy about being manhandled, so we're going to get her into this nice spot as quickly as possible, where she's got a choice of disappearing into the undergrowth or climbing the tree. There you go, Glenn. Here it is.
You alright?
So this brave little chick survived 3 days in a container with a boa, and the boa chose not to eat it. So Alejandro and his family are going to take the chick. So the family.
Lucky bird. As Jonny was saying, this habitat's going to be perfect. You need a boat to access it. There's not going to be any people here to come across them. I mean, it's got some pretty spiky branches. It's quite a hostile environment, but perfect for the snakes. Lots of undergrowth, lots of branches, lots of food to eat. They've got water around them, got mangrove if they want, all kinds of environments. So I think they're going to be some very happy snakes.
I'm excited for you, Beau Marshall.
Beau Marshall, the last snake to be released.
Yay!
Yeah. What were the other names?
We had Bertha.
The big one?
Big one, mad one. La Enojadita.
Yeah.
And Rick Bowman.
Oh, so finally Beau Marshall, right?
Finally Beau Marshall.
Okay, Jonny reckons this is a good spot. Yeah, it looks nice.
So Beau Marshall, as we've named him, is very chill, not too intimidated by us. You can see very gentle, adorable. So because he's quite small, we're gonna release him into this habitat amongst the mangroves because it's a lot easier for him to climb. He's got the option of getting up. If he does want to go low though and get in amongst those mangrove roots or into the vegetation just beyond, he's still got plenty of options. Does anyone else want to handle him?
Yeah, kind of.
Go on then, Mika.
Oh, sorry. Scary. So chill, Beau. It's nice to meet you in your final home. He wants to go. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you want to do this?
Thank you.
So done. I think that was a really successful release. All three boas out back into the wild. All three seem to have embraced their new surroundings. It's so good to see them back out in the wild, exploring, probably for the first time in years, some of them. So we're really happy to see them back out in the wild, enjoying their new habitat in a safe place. So thanks for joining us. It's been great.
Successful mission overall. Well done, everyone.
Woo!
Whoa! Okay, we're gonna go cool off by jumping into that sea.
Let's go.